class. I am your teacher Shweta Alam, faculty of English from Maitri Lower and Higher Primary School. Dear students, in previous class we have discussed about the apple tree. So in this class I am going to teach a lesson, Manu and the Money. So you have some of the listening stories from your textbook. Page number 120. That means take out 120. Manu and the Money. Yes. What happened with Manu? What happened with Money? You will see in this story. One day, Manu was going to his grandma's house. On the way, he found a 500 rupee note. He picked it up and looked it here and there to know whose money it was. He didn't find anyone around. So he kept the money with him and went on. After some time, he felt thirsty. He didn't have water. He saw a grocer's shop nearby. He went to the shop and asked for water. The shopkeeper said, I don't have water right now, but I have juice bottles. If you want, you can buy juice." Manu took a juice bottle and paid for it. He drank the juice. He drank the juice and started walking again. A little later, he found a woman on the road who was searching for something. He stopped there and asked the woman, "What are you searching for, auntie?" The woman replied, "I have lost my 500 rupee note. I need the money urgently. I must take medicine for my son who is in the hospital." The boy then realized it and said, "Oh, auntie, please stop searching. I have your money. I found it a little behind on the park. I didn't see anyone around. So I kept the money with me. Now take this and buy medicine." Manu continued, "But auntie, I'm so sorry. I bought a juice bottle worth rupees 20 from your money as I was very thirsty. Here's rupees 480. I'm really sorry. I will return your 20 rupees after I go home, auntie. Please give me your address." The woman was happy at the boy's honesty. She blessed him and rushed to the hospital. Yes. Dear student, this is the story about honesty. How is the boy was honestful boy? You will see in this story. So, let's start the story. One day Manu was going to his grandma's house. Where was he going? Yes. He was going to his grandma's house. On the way, he found a 500 rupee note. How many rupees note?
500 rupee note.
Do you see the 500 rupee note, dear students?
Yes.
Commonly, you all know see the 500 rupee notes. If you don't see, you will ask your father for showing the 500 rupee note. Okay. One day, Manu was going to his grandma's house. On the way, he found a 500 rupee note. He picked it up and looked here and there to know whose money it was. He didn't find anyone around. When he saw a 500 rupee note, juice. I don't have water bottles. I have only juice bottles. If you want, you can buy juice. Okay. Manu took a juice bottle and paid for it. He drank the juice and started walking again. Yes. He drank the juice and next he started. He continued his journey. Where he is going? Yes, he is going to his grandma's house. A little later, he found a woman on the road who was searching for something. On the road, he saw a woman. What she is doing? She is searching for something. What she is searching? Let's see the story. He stopped there and asked the woman, "What are you searching for, auntie? What are you searching here? What happened to with you?" The boy asked to auntie. The woman replied, "I have lost my 500 rupees notes." How many rupee note? 500 rupee note. I have lost 500 rupee note. I need money urgently. I must take medicine for my son who is in the hospital. He is badly injured. He is in hospital. He rushed to the hospital. I need money urgently, but I lost my 500 rupee note. Who said this? The woman said to the boy. The boy then realized and said, "Oh, auntie, I have your money. You stop searching. I have your money. I found it a little behind on the path. Little behind after some time later. That means while I am coming from this road, I saw your 500 rupee note. I kept it in myself. I have your money. Don't searching. Please stop your searching. I didn't see anyone around. I saw, looked around it, but I can't see. I don't find anyone from around me. So I kept your money and went. So I kept the money with me and now take this and buy medicine." He returned to the money to woman. How many rupees he returned? Let's see. Manu continued, "But auntie, I'm so sorry." He asked, apologized. "Yes, sorry. I bought a juice bottle worth rupees 20. How many rupees he worth? He worth 20 rupees. Why he worth 20 rupees? Because he worth 20 rupees for juice bottle. Okay. Yes, he worth 20 rupees for juice. Okay, I was very thirsty. Here's rupees 480 rupees. Okay, dear student, you minus 20 rupees from 500 rupees. How many? Amount is 480 rupees. So the boy have 480 rupees. He returned to his auntie and he worked 20 rupees for juice bottle because he is very thirsty. So he drank juice for worth 20 rupees. "I am really sorry. I will return you 20 rupees after I go home, auntie." Yes. The boy's honest is he will return to 20 rupees to his auntie and please give me your address. He asking address to woman for the returning for 20 rupees. The woman was happy at the boy's honesty. She was very happy for looking the boy's honestness. Okay. She blessed him and rushed to the hospital. Next, after she blessed him, she wished to him and rushed to the hospital because yes, her son was very injured. He is in hospital. So he need money for urgent repairs. She got the money from the boy and went to the hospital. Okay, dear student, where was Manu going? Manu was going to his grandma's house. Okay. Who did Manu ask for water? Manu asked the water to shopkeeper. What was the woman searching? The woman was searching for 500. Yes, the man who gave money to the woman. Okay, ladies, present. I hope you understood this story.
So
read it loudly. Okay, this is very simple. Dear student, does it is used with singular form. First you identify the sentence it is in past tense. Okay, so first example, Kamala works hard is in simple present tense. How to identify is this sentence in simple present tense? Yes, you will be easily understand from look at the verb. I add s with verb. So it is in singular simple present tense. When the subject is singular, we add s with verb. Here, Kamala works hard. How to find question? Does Kamala work hard? Second one. He looks small. Here, does he look small? It runs mostly. Does it run mostly? You lift as from verb. Look at here. Suma reads loudly. Does Suma read loudly? Yes, it is very easy. And next, do. How to use do? Do, it is used with plural. Do, plural form. How to find question? I work hardly. I work hard. So, do I work hardly? Question, do I work hardly? I, it is also considered with plural form in English. From, okay, second, birds fly high. It is in simple present tense. So, birds, subject is birds. Subject is in plural form. So, we use do. Do birds fly high? Fly high. Teachers teach lesson. It is in simple present tense. So teachers, it is plural form. When subject is plural, you don't add s with verb. So you can easily identify by looking at the verb and noun. If subject is singular, you add s. If subject is plural, you don't add s with verb. Here, teachers, is this singular or plural? Plural. So do teachers teach lesson? Very simple. Okay, dear student, do it is used with plural form and does it is used with singular form. You look at the sentence. The sentence it is in singular. Sentence it is in simple present tense. Subject is singular. So we use does. The sentence it is in simple present tense. You look at the subject. Subject. If subject is plural, you add do. Okay. Okay, dear student. In next class, we will discussing about use of do and does. Okay.